fact of who my dad was, you know, he was like, oh, he's the coolest cat on the planet. He's playing guitar and people are clapping and they're enjoying it. He loved playing. He really did. You know, he really enjoyed playing guitars. He loved all his heroes. So that's, you know, Charlie Christian and Carl Hogan and T-Bone Walker, you know, back in high school. He was kind of a bit of a rebel. You know, they have the school functions in the gymnasium. He gets out, starts singing Confessing the Blues. Got in a lot of trouble for it. But even then, it was like he got a fantastic reaction because these kids aren't supposed to like this stuff, you know. He got a reaction as a teenager. It was like, maybe I'll roll with that at some point. And, you know, he put the hammer down, picked this thing up and kept on rolling. It's like, okay, let's see. What's going to appeal to the largest number of people possible? And what's going to feed my family? And that's where Maybellene came from.
Maybellene, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybellene, why can't you be true?
A lot of the music that he wrote were from life experience. And, you know, his formula was simple. Write about love, write about fun, write about cars. My dad was an absolute car fanatic. So, red convertible, which is in the Smithsonian, red 355, 45, 35, wine red 350. He had a wine red Cadillac Fleetwood. Can I listen to music of today or since he started and not be able to pick stuff out? It's literally and virtually impossible. Major rock acts, but they all readily admit they were all influenced by my dad's playing, Muddy Waters playing, Howlin' Wolf playing, Hubert Sumlin's playing. Other people was like, ooh, that sounds really cool. I said, oh, that came from so-and-so. You know, I know where that came from. And then I'll go home and try and play it. How is it that I'm now holding a brand new, as authentic as it gets, ES-350T? Gibson wanted to do a guitar with my dad. The specs of this thing, it's dead on the money. I mean, the binding's correct. The sides are beautiful. It's more that quilt. I mean, it's quilt all the way through. The parallelograms, all of that's correct. Neck taper is perfect. This maple top is superb. I love it. You know, from the clusens up on top, you guys went back to the correct pots. And it feels like it. The roll up on them, the sounds right. Well, you know, it's got the black dog ear P90s in it. So that's the dog ear with the gold screws on it. And the tone that comes out of these are just fat. You know, real nice and creamy. Some people like that extra volume, extra, you know, because you're literally pushing a little more voltage through this single coil. I want to hook this up to some, like, monster amp and just crank it. Dad never used effects. It was just volume. I mean, everything about this thing. Everything, I mean, tailpieces. What was told to me is that the goal was to make them as authentic as possible. And this is as authentic as possible. I can see it, man. This is fabulous. I mean, it's absolutely perfect. Perfect.